Here's an Endermat servo drive, model number DDS03.1-W030-R. And this servo drive is booting up to alarm 61. Overcurrent short to ground. Let me power it up. Watch this display right here. There we go. Alarm 61. We're going to have to fix that. Let's tear into that drive and see what we can do. Take the drive apart and get down to the power board where the IGBT and current sensors sit. So I get them put back to where they're supposed to. There's one, two, three, one, and two. Thank you. we're going to take a look at the four current sense output voltages to see if anybody's different. Y'all see that okay? First one. That's VCC to ground, 10.28 volts DC. Here's the output, 5.16 volts DC. Here's the second current sense. VCC to ground, 10.28 volts DC. Here's the output. 9.27 volts. That's a little bit high compared to this last one. Let's see what the other two look like. There's VCC to ground, 10.28 volts DC. Here's its output, 5.15 volts DC. Here's the last one over here. There's VCC to ground, 10.28 volts DC. Its output is 5.16 volts DC. This one here, something's going on with this one here. Its output is higher than the others at 9.27 volts DC. We'll pull these current senses and put some new ones in there. Here's our new current sense module we're going to put in there. Right, let's flip this over and get the old one took out. new one installed. Just put everything together and we'll test it. Now we're going to look at that current sense output. It should be 5, not 9. There's our VCC to ground, 10.28 volts DC. Here's the output. All right, 5.14 volts DC. It's not 9 volts anymore. We'll put the drive back together, see if it boots up good. See if we fix that alarm 61 fault. We're installing the personality module that holds the parameters. Program module. Here's the I.O. card, the DAE 1.1. Connect the bus power supply to the servo drive. Connect our DC voltages through this harness right here, this wiring harness, to the X1 connector. Now the last drive in series with the bus power supply, the very last drive needs this. That little terminating connector. So we install that on the other side of the X1 connector. Our connections to the DAE 1.1 card. It needs 24 volts DC. Apply that to the red wire and ground to the 24 volt DC power supply. It's going to go to this black wire. That's the plus UL and 0 VL pins on that cord right there. I'm going to get me some cardboard to insulate those wires from the drive so they don't short out against the drive. Now, E1 and E2 on the cord is your speed reference in. I'm going to use a potentiometer. The wings of the potentiometer are going to be going to this power supply right here that's set to plus and minus 10 volts. So the ground, I connect to the E2 terminal, the ground to the plus or minus 10 volt power supply. Minus 10 is going to go to one wing of that potentiometer. Plus 10 is going to go to the other side of that potentiometer. He's going to go to E2. There's our analog speed reference connections. Now here's the RF and the AH terminal. I got a couple of resistors that I can clip onto to activate this drive. They get pulled up to plus 24. Attach right here. Okay, that's going to be our switches for the AH and the RF terminals. Now we need to hook up TM plus and TM minus, that's the motor thermals, and I've got a little jumper right here. Some motors that come into the shop have a brake, and that's what these extra wires are, to release the brake, the mechanical brake on that motor that has it. Our motor doesn't have a mechanical brake, so I'm just going to let these wires float in the wind. We need to hook up the resolver to this connector from the servo motor. UV and W connect here. Then I got to hook up L1, L2, and L3 to the bus power supply. That's 220 volts AC. And you see we have two wires that come off of L1 and L2 that come down here to terminals 8 and 9 that power up the control voltages inside this bus power supply. All right, I'll move the camera out of the way. We'll set the servo motor down here and hook up the line voltage. These two big motors are going to bookend our servo motor so it don't roll around if things go badly. Here's our little servo motor. Back to that servo drive. The resolver connects to X4 on the servo drive. Here's the UV and W. Connect the line. Not plugged into the wall yet. Frame ground the motor to the drive. There we go. Got a little clip. Fire up. Okay. It didn't come up alarm 61. Looks like we're fixed. Let's see if we can run that motor. Let's see where our speed reference is first. We want that motor to run away. Set the speed reference. There's 2 volts. Be back on 2.025 volts. We'll get it. Oh, there's a 157 millivolts. That should be low enough where that motor won't take off and run. RF terminal. Now, we're going to connect the AH terminal. There we're going. Speed it up a little bit. We fixed it. Current sense module. Bad current sense module. Cause that drive to trip on alarm 61. Amazing. I'm gonna move the camera over in front of that 7-segment display and you'll see it. How it boots up now. Okay, I'm applying 220 volts AC to the bus power supply. Look at that. No alarm 61. All right. Now, I'm going to connect the RF terminal to plus 24 volts DC. 7-segment display says AH. Now, I'm going to connect the AH terminal to plus 24 volts DC. 7-segment display say AF, and the motor's running. Nice. We fixed it. Okay. All right.